Yeah, you know, it's I'm coming from Piemonte. It's a very famous area for wine, and you know, we have a special wine that the older you get, better you get as well. And then I hope to be a little bit with this kind of wine. It means that I would like to run Le Mans still. I don't know. We wait this time, and then I tell you after this race.
But you know, the best age for the Pallone is about 8 years.
Yeah. I'm only 16 years or 17 with you. I am still 1 year.
That's true. Yeah. It's only 16 years.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. No, but Le Mans is, you know, for every driver is something special. Every year you would like to come here. For sure, once I will not come here as driver, I will come as spectator. That's for sure. Yeah, I think probably it's the first time that we are coming, in the last 10 years, that we are coming here to Le Mans, not as a champion, I would say. But the feeling I have, or the pressure I feel, is exactly the same like in the year before when we were coming here as champion. It means that this year probably the pressure is even higher, because we know that we have to take back to Ingolstadt the trophy. And you know, when you are here as champion, you say, okay, we have done it already last year, we have done it 2 years before, and then probably it's an easy way or to lose a little bit the focus on the race. But because last year we did not win, now we have to be even more focused on the race, and that's why we are ready to fight even harder than in the year before.
Tom, first of all, we've been able to read your chronicle, in fact, on the site on your Endurance Info, which has been a long series, and I think we're in the last episode now. But my basic question is, here, June 2010, how do you feel in relation to June 2009?
I think we all feel better. Last year there was no pre-test before Le Mans, which is an important issue when you come to this unique and very special racetrack. We had won with our R15 TDI last year in Sebring, so we were having a good feeling about the car, but we could not be able to test in the configuration we would love to have raced in Le Mans due to a lot of issues with weather and no pre-test. So we feel much better now. We have done a lot of testing, we have done races with the car, and we feel that with this open car philosophy, we are at the very close to where we actually want to be.
Tom, in fact, you've had the opportunity of driving a car which was rather different to the Audis, which was when you won in the Bentley in 2003. What sort of memories does that leave you?
I have a lot of it. It's my 14th start at Le Mans, so memories is always involved at Le Mans. The Bentley year was unique as any year, but obviously what I remember most was driving a close car, and a close car was very good and very efficient down the straights, and in many ways it gave an aerodynamic advantage, which we definitely had that year. And this is something which I remember as let's say maybe the most. But it was a good year with a lot of British influence. But obviously it was always an Audi engine under the skin of for me maybe the most beautiful car. But a beautiful car is the winning car, and I think we all three teams here would like to make sure that the most beautiful car this year is the one they are loading behind us at the moment.